All right, new tonight, thousands of dead fish turning up along the banks of the Tennessee River. It might sound strange, but it's actually been a good thing for the river. News Channel 5's Chris Conti went on the water today to show us why.
It's beautiful.
Appearances along the banks of the Tennessee River are deceiving.
I am using red worms and wax worms. They're not biting too good.
Marilyn Baker has learned that well.
I'm not trying to catch dinner.
No bites for the 68-year-old today. Ironic, considering over the last few weeks, fish have been throwing themselves upon the shore.
And they were everywhere.
It was the end of April when anglers and officials noticed the problem. Tens of thousands of dead fish lining the shoreline. Pictures, though, do little to convey the smell.
Have you ever had hamburger meat in your refrigerator and it went bad? It smelled like rotten meat.
But bizarre as it all may sound, it was a welcome sight in Henry County.
Picked a good day to come out here.
As the CEO of the County Alliance, David Hamilton has spent years dealing with the invasion of Asian carp, the same jumping invasive species that are now washing up on the shore.
We don't want them down along the shore, obviously, but we'd like to get rid of them.
Scientists have spent years trying to find ways to kill the Asian carp, but it turns out the answer may lie with Mother Nature.
If there's something that's caused it that we can figure out a way to replicate to other fish, then it'll be a solution.
TWRA believes the carp, not native to North America, may have succumbed to bacteria in the water.
They're not supposed to be here.
Unwelcome guests on these deceivingly beautiful waters, whose untimely end may help fix a complex problem.
They got to figure out some solution.
Chris Conti.
It's a challenge.
News Channel 5.
Thank you, Chris. The TWRA has collected samples of the Asian carp and sent them off for testing. They hope those results might shed some light on what's causing this fish kill.